So let's get this out of the way. This is one of my favorite episodes of the season. And no, not just because Discord is in it, though that is a good chunk of my reasoning. We'll get to more of that in a second. To have two main characters that we were not anticipating to get married in, to actually marry them in an episode is something really foreign to the show, especially for a character like Sugarbell. The show, almost to a default, does not do romantic encounters. Sugarbell even appeared as late as season 5. Surely it would have been more natural to eventually pair him off with another character that was introduced earlier in the series. As is, the key points of their relationship did develop on screen, so at least there's that. They are pretty cute anyway. I do wish the staff thought of this earlier. Poor Marvel Man. But for a late-blooming relationship, it was handled pretty well. Now let's get to Discord. I'll save all my long-term character development notes for the finale, but I wanted to note here is how pure Discord is. He's genuinely excited for the engagement, and even though he messes things up, he still tries to help his friends, and I love it. He's so cute. Soon you'll leave me. I can't handle that. We start off in a reality TV-style interview where all the characters were blaming each other for things. Cut to where it all started.
Flashback.
Big Mac shows off his bling when Discord shows up, and I do enjoy that Discord can't keep a secret, and it's adorable. Look how big his eyes get, Babu. Discord, who's already feeling left out due to what was established in the last episode with the guys, starts off feeling left out right away, so his participation isn't all that enthused. After Sugarbell is blind and Spike messes up Mrs. Cake's desserts, I mean, you can't just call them flaming fondue, right? Discord tries to make the apples talk. That goes about as well as you'd expect. Discord, after realizing he messes up, kinda cheats. I genuinely think he didn't do this on purpose. He just wasn't careful. Whoops. Back at Sugar Cube Corner, everyone regroups.
Sugarbell!
Dr. Scott!
Janet!
Ah!
Rook! Janet!
Dr. Scott!
Janet!
Shrek!
Fiona!
Mom!
Harold!
Duncan!
Mrs. Cake!
What did I do?
Nothing. I thought we were just saying each other's names.
Oh, and the apples come back. Oh, turns out Sugarbell was gonna propose to Big Mac by the desserts. That's progressive. Woman knows what she wants. The CMC also don't help. They can't seem to find a Big Mac.
Big Mac!
Good continuity, though. Oh, did you guys catch Granny's reference? Because Grandpere is voiced by William Shatner.
And we were in outer space on some kind of mission to explore a strange new world. And Mudbriar was there, being as logical as ever. But his ears was all horny-like. And then Discord showed up. He's pretty much the same.
Even though he doesn't say anything outside that one episode, but it's important to remember.
I remember.
Discord doing his raptor stance is also adorable, and I love it. I also like the Mrs. Cake and Discord implied ship. That was funny. So it looks like everyone screwed up, not just Discord. I think he just wanted to be the only one not blamed for once. Poor Babu. Everyone always blames him for stuff. In the end though, it works out because Big Mac and Sugarbell get to reflect on what's really important to them. Damn horses are sweet. Discord even fixes stuff. He cares. And then the wedding happens, and it's great, and Discord loves it. A couple of things. No main six. I figured some of them would show up. I get it, it's a small wedding, but they all knew Big Mac much longer than Discord did. Right? Sigh. Oh, and I guess Starlight killed Sugarbell's parents or something?
What's the dog's name?
Max. Hey, Janelle. What's wrong with Wolfie?
Wolfie's fine, honey. Wolfie's just fine. What are you?
Your foster parents are dead.
Maybe she's estranged from them, maybe? Would explain why she joined a cult, but the apples, like, made me laugh in real life. He's just trying to help, man. Throughout the episode, it's pretty easy to track Discord's psychology. At first he's excited, but then he feels left out. That's why his ego is super into play in this episode, because he feels pretty inferior throughout all of this. From his non-understanding of love, to him trying to get creative. He wants to contribute in a unique way. You can just tell by how excited he was about the announcement. But when things go wrong, he doesn't want to feel like it's all his fault. This is a big deal to his friend. He just wants to feel like a valued part of it. It's adorable. That's why he values Fluttershy so much, because even if he messes up on accident, Fluttershy will believe him. No one else will, and doesn't want to feel like he screws things up consistently for the people he cares about. And for the people that care for him, more importantly. This episode works because, instead of using a standard plot like body switching, it relies on the characters and their relationships with each other to make a compelling and heartwarming conflict that's unique, which is always the recipe for a good episode, for starters. The pacing is great, as well as using point of view storytelling to have fun with the structure of the story. Plus, Discord is at a better written than matter of principle self. I don't know if you guys remember, but in Matter of Principles, his selfish side was kind of ruling the whole show, and he was kind of mean butt, and it wasn't fun. His ego and his slight uncaring probably could have been toned down just a little bit, though, Mike. He also is a sweet bean at times here, and I do enjoy sweet bean Discord. Sweet bean Discord will cure cancer, I promise. And that's all, folks, except it's not time for the ending gag.
You can do it!
Dragon! Oh. But he was still Trogdon! Trogdon! And the Trogdor comes in and... No!
Don't leave anything out!
Oh, she's the one, Cole!
That they made it all work out.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching. Click here to subscribe, we really appreciate it. Don't forget to turn your notifications on to get notified every time we make a new video. Click here to check out the main collaborator for the video, usually the editor. Click here to check out our video playlist for this video, where you'll find similar videos that you might just like, hopefully. There's also a credits scroll here where you can check out all the other awesome contributors. All their info is in the description. That's all I gotta say, KP away!